Namaskaram to all of you. Chalo, let's start with our residential status concept. This is the next basic concept that you must understand. This is the chapter as a whole. This whole chapter is covered in section 6 of income tax. Yesterday we have initiated discussion of section 5. Alright, it has not been completed. Unless and until section 9 is completed, the discussion will still going on, okay? And section 9 we are going to discuss tomorrow. Today's target is to finish residential status and rates of tax in India, alright? So this is the target for today's. There are 4 subsections that I will be teaching you in detail so far as the residential status is concerned. Out of 4 subsections, subsection 1 is complicated in nature, at the same time it is important because it is going to come in exam for sure, 100% again. Okay, this section comes in exam at intermediate for 100% level, because this is the chapter through which you understand the first stage of determination of taxes. Taxes are applicable according to residential status. So there are 3 status we have in India: ordinary resident, non-ordinary resident and non-resident. Out of these 3, you tell me who should be paying highest amount of taxes. Ordinary resident, because you people are using Indian infrastructure, Indian resources to the greatest level. Yes or no? Who should not pay tax in India? Non-resident, because there someone is living in China, Japan, Canada, they should not pay tax in India unless they have Indian income. Unless they have Indian. If they have Indian income, then they must pay tax in India. So far as non-ordinary resident is concerned, yesterday only we have discussed, non-ordinary resident has to pay tax on Indian income, because everybody pay tax on Indian income. At the same time, he must pay tax on one more income which is there in foreign nation, but it's controlled from India. You understand? If this happens, then he has to pay tax. So overpay tax on 3 income: Indian income, foreign income, business control from India, and pure foreign income. NORPay tax on 2 income: Indian income and business control from India. Other income he doesn't pay tax. And NRPay only tax on Indian income, not on any other income. Yes? Okay. So this is how we have discussed. Sir, but how to become OR, how to become NOR, how to become NR? So for that we have to discuss residential status chapter first, and then we will take our discussion continue again back to scope of total income, because scope of total income is completely interdependent on residential status, these 2 chapters. So either you need to read for residential status first and then scope of total income. We have initiated scope of total income, now we are studying residential status. These 2 chapters are not independent, although questions comes independent in exam, but from my angle, from your angle, from the understanding of tax perspective, these 2 are one concept. Because first we need to check your residential status. According to that, I can tell you which income is taxable and which income is not taxable in India. If you tell me, sir, I'm Chris Gale, I come to India very for like 30 to 40 days in a year, then I will say you are a non-resident. Then you will ask me, sir, then which income is taxable in India? Only your Indian income is taxable. Sometime you will say, sir, I live in Jogeshwari, I have never left country, so I'm ordinary resident. What type of incomes are taxable for me? Can I have debentures in Canada? Will that interest in Canada, which is accrued in Canada, will be taxable in India? Answer is yes, because you are ordinary resident, your global income is taxable in India. So which income is taxable and which income is not taxable? Before that, you must tell me what is your residential status. Okay, this happens, this chapter is important only for those people who travel continuously, like Virat Kohli, like movie actors, Anushka Sharma and all. They continuously travel, business class people, they continuously travel abroad. Yes or no? For them this chapter is important. For you and me this chapter is not that important, because we know our status, we don't have to compute it. But for foreigners who comes to India and for Indians who goes to foreign, this chapter is must. Assuming Virat Kohli is your client, okay? Last year Virat Kohli has visited 9 different countries, okay? You should understand residential status of 9 different nations, because sometime Virat Kohli may not be resident in India, but he may become resident in Sri Lanka. You don't know Sri Lanka's law, I don't know Australia's law, you understand? So if Virat Kohli is your client, you cannot tell him, okay, you are non-resident in India, balance 8 country I don't know. Hello? That is not possible. You have to tell him everything, and therefore when this chapter reaches to practical implication level, it becomes complicated. because you need to have understanding of multiple nations income tax. This is our income tax, Indian income tax. I am going to teach how to become resident in India as per Indian income tax. I cannot teach you how to become resident in Dubai, how to become resident in USA. That Dubai income tax will say, that US income tax will say. But if you are having client who is visiting these countries, then you must understand these both laws. You understand in practical life. This is practical life. Theoretical life is different, practical life is different. Okay? Alright? So this chapter is serious or not serious? From Virat Kohli's angle. Serious. Why? Because if you change his status from NR to OR, his Indian income as well as foreign incomes are going to become taxable in India. And therefore his residential status is must. And we compute residential status every single year. Every single year. Because there is no assurance or guarantee that this year you are in India, next year also you will be in India. Every year your residential status may change. And therefore this is year on year activity. This is not permanent activity. You were citizen of India, you are citizen of India. Your citizenship will not change not automatically, but your residential status may change. Residential status means whether you are residing in India or not. So residing means stay. You must stay in India. Yahan pe, physically rukna hai aapko yahan pe. If you stay, right now if I ask you where do you stay, so you will say, I stay in Mumbai. Yes. That's what, I stay in India. I did not ask you, are you Indian citizen? You may be foreign citizen, you may be Indian citizen. Where are you staying now? India. Then you may become Indian resident. Indian? Resident. I'm not teaching you citizenship. Okay, I'm teaching you Indian residential status that you get out of number of days stay in India. And you need to stay 182 days. Thank you. You need to stay 182 days in India to become resident. Yesterday we spoke about it, I guess. Give me a second. Can you put this there in board? Alright, so you need to stay in India for how many days I told you? 182 days. This is condition 1. That means approximately half year you should stay in India, around approximate 6 months you should stay in India, then you may become Indian resident. Alright, there is one more condition. There are two basic conditions we have. Alright, and those two basic conditions I'll be teaching you. Yes, thanks. Okay, two basic conditions I'll be teaching you in this chapter. I can teach you conditions to become resident. I cannot teach you conditions to become non-resident. If you are resident, congratulations. Okay. If you are not resident, then you are non-resident. Hello. Yes. I don't have conditions to become non-resident. I can teach you conditions to become resident. If you don't become resident, then you are non-resident. So non-resident is the impact. Okay. Resident is the cause. Hello. So you need to understand how to become a resident. So there are two conditions. Both conditions we call them as the basic condition. You need to satisfy only one condition out of basic condition. You don't have to satisfy both conditions. You just have to satisfy one condition out of two conditions. And those, see, it is written here. Satisfied anyone. Yesterday I told you to underline this word. Satisfied anyone. You don't have to satisfy both. Out of basic condition, you must satisfy only one condition. If you satisfy one condition, then you will become resident. If you don't satisfy condition 1 as well as condition 2, hello, then you will become non-resident because you are not a resident, SSC. So definition of non-resident is a negative in India. It's not positive definition. Who is non-resident? A person other than resident is a non-resident. So to understand who is non-resident, you must understand what is resident. I cannot say, sir, resident is a person other than non-resident. There cannot be two simultaneous negative definition in my law. If one definition is negative, the other one has to be positive in nature. Am I clear? Okay, so those conditions I will be teaching you. If you become resident, then we must ask you whether you are ordinary resident in India or a non-ordinary resident in India. Because according to this also, your level of income is going to change. That we have discussed. Whether you are ordinary resident in India or non-ordinary resident in India. Ordinary means you and me people ordinarily, hum yahan ki hai. Alright. Non-ordinary means Vijay Mallya uncle, these cricketers, these movie actors who travel abroad very frequently. Business class people. Hello. Alright. Sometimes they stay in India, sometimes they stay abroad. So hume dekhna padega who is ordinary resident and who is non-ordinary resident. Only if you are a resident. If somebody is non-resident, you cannot ask this question to him. Tum India mein kabhi kabhi nahi rehte ho ki kabhi nahi rehte ho? Alright, that is the wrong question to wrong person, you understand? And therefore this question you must ask only if person becomes resident. First is to check whether he is a resident. Then you must satisfy both additional condition. You are model use the language dual condition. Dual means two. Okay, both conditions you must satisfy to become OR. If you don't satisfy both condition, then by default you are NOR. Hello. To become OR, you have to satisfy two condition. So allow me to teach you in this way. To become resident, you must satisfy three conditions. One condition of residence, and then two conditions of ordinary resident. Then only you will become OR. You check whether you people are OR or not according to conditions. First you check your own status, then you determine others. Alright, sir, how to determine that residential status? So this is the format, or these are the conditions that we have to discuss in this chart. Alright, this is the pattern that you are going to follow in exam. You understand format of writing answers. Alright, your institute write answers in paragraph. My difficulty is that you may write answer in paragraph, but then you don't control your emotions. You just write anything. Alright, you write your own English, you put anything that you comes to your mind. You write background of the story which is not required. So when we write in paragraph, we go unlimited. Whereas institute doesn't want unlimited. Institute wants very precise answer. Okay, so this format will help you to give precise answer, cut to cut answer, nothing more, nothing less. This much is required and only this much is required, not more than this, not less than this. Am I clear? Alright, so sir, basic condition. Now Roman 1, basic condition, because first we need to check whether he is a resident. First basic condition, I have already told you, stay of 182 days or more in India during previous year. So sir, you need to stay during previous year to become resident in assessment year. Hello?
Yes.
We are determining residential status for assessment year 1920. But to check whether you are resident in 1920, we check data of previous year. Because assessment year has just started. Nobody knows whether I am going to stay in India in 1920 or no. Even I don't know. I may go abroad. Lekin tu is saal India mein tha na? Yes. So you will become resident for previous year 1819 and assessment year 1920. Am I clear? So that where you should stay, come on, tell me where you should stay in India during previous year or assessment year? Previous year. Kitna din? Sir, did you stay? I'm asking, did you stay in India for more than 182 days? How many days you stayed in previous year? Previous year means April 18 se leke March 19 tak. How many days you will be staying in India? 182 or usse zyada? Usse, you will be staying here ordinary situation for 365 days. So are you resident? Whether this condition is satisfied? So yahan pe likhne ka satisfied. Okay, yahan pe number of days likhne, number of days stayed in India. Aur remark mein hume likhna hai satisfied or not satisfied. Satisfied. Okay, if I tell you, okay, you use your brain. If I tell you that if you stay in India for more than 182 days, you will become resident. And then also you will become ordinary resident. I'm sure. You are resident and ordinary resident. Haan toh sir kya ho jayega? Your global income is going to become taxable in global income. Now you are a Virat Kohli or you are any responsible person who is earning in crores. Not only in India but also outside. Don't you think you will apply your brain? Hello? And will try to evolve something. Do some calculation through which you can save taxes. Hello? See, nobody can save taxes on Indian income, because whether you are OR, NOR or NR, it has to be paid. And nobody hesitate to pay tax on Indian income, because you are earning in India, obviously you will like to pay taxes in India. People hesitate to pay taxes in India on foreign income. Hello? You are Virat Kohli playing in Canada or Australia, and then he has to come back and he have to pay tax on that income in India. That hurts. Can you tell me the consultancy that you will give to Virat Kohli so that his Australian income should not become taxable in India? What should he do? He should not stay in India for more than? Bas, aisa logo ne kiya. People have done this. So Virat Kohli is to count his number of days. 170 ho gaya, chalo. Ghumne chalte. They have money to go abroad. They can just go on family vacation. Hello. So they were planning, not Virat Kohli, I'm just taking example, okay? Any people, any foreigner, any business class, any of cricketer, any sportman who is having enough money in their bank account, they were planning in a such a manner that they should not be staying in India for more than 182 days. Because if they stay in India for more than 182 days, they will become resident. And if they become resident, there is a good chance that they will become ordinary resident. And if they become ordinary resident, their global income is going to become taxable in India, which is the problem. All right. And therefore, these people started manipulation. Simple manipulation. Do not stay in India for more than 180 days. So you will not become resident. You will become non-resident. And if you become non-resident, you are only Indian income is taxable in India. Okay, very simple tax planning that people were doing. As the government, we observe this particular situation. Everybody is flying abroad continuously. If 5-6 months have gone, everybody is going abroad. Acha match bhi nahi hai. Aise ja raha hai. All right. And then we observe these people are having no mood to pay tax on foreign income. Although we have created law, but they are not having mood to pay tax on foreign income. Yes or no? And this class is the lower class or higher class? And higher class should pay tax in India. Please understand, because they are earning money, they have capacity to pay tax. Without taxes, our nation cannot run. We cannot run the nation. Hello? Yes. To run nation, we need so resources. And rich people are earning resources. There is nothing wrong in sharing your 30% of resources with government of India for overall good. Hello? Alright? And therefore, government has amended the second condition. Second condition states now, if you stay in India, okay, for 60 days or more during PY, you will become a resident. So, tum bola to bolo fir sir, wo first condition kyu padhaya? 60 days ka condition hai, to after 61 days you will become a resident. So, 182 kya uska koi sense hi nahi banta? You tell me, if I give you pass up to church gate, can you get down in Jogeshwari, Andheri? Tell me, koi bhi station, there is no point, you understand? Koi condition bana ke matlab hi nahi. 182 days ka condition kyu banaya? Already there is a 60 days condition. First of all, 60 days condition came after 182 days condition, and secondly, 60 days condition is not alone. Okay, it needs support of condition 2. So second condition is divided into two parts. Part A, part B. I with love call it Chotu A, Chotu B. Alright, Chotu A says you must stay in India for 60 days or more. Okay, and in dono ke beech mein kya hai? And है वो red ink में लिखना है ये and important है and ये और important है either first if you stay in India for 190 days resident yes. You will not even check second condition. Why to check second condition? You are already resident. Yes. If you are already resident, then don't even write second condition. No need to write because you already become resident. You understand? Second condition we should write only if you are not satisfying first condition. Okay, so you stayed in India for 120 days. Yes. Hello. So you did not satisfy 120 days, not satisfied. Yes or no? Yes. If you write not satisfied there, then only you should put or second condition Chotu A, stay of 60 days or more in India during PY. I said 120 days you stayed. Did you satisfy this condition? Yes. Yes. Will you declare my residency status here? No. Because there is one more condition, sir, that we must satisfy, and that condition stay of 365 days or more. Stay of 365 days or more in India during, oh, both important, during 4 years immediately preceding to previous year. 4 years immediately preceding to previous year or preceding to previous year. Tumhara previous year kya fir se batao? 18-19. You tell me what are the previous 4 years? Iske pehle ke 4 saal. 18-19 na tumhara hai. To 17-18, 16, 17, 15, 16, 14, 15. इतना है, ठीक है? इतने सारे हैं. Marker कहाँ है? नहीं, वो तो नहीं निकाल पाऊँगा. चलो ठीक है. Alright, इतने सारे तो हैं. Okay. इन चार सालों में, you need to stay in India for 365 days. You tell me if you are Indian, your family is in India. Okay, if you're an Indian cricketer or you're Indian businessman, I believe in 4 years you can stay in India for more than 365 days. Yes. So which planning is failed now? Not staying for more than. If you want to play with government now, So you should not stay for more than 60 days in India. Lekin agar itna sab India mein, toh I believe 60 days at least you will stay here.
Yes.
Alright, and therefore lot of people like this who were doing this evasion, they are captured now.
Yeah.
Okay, in condition two. So that planning will not work. Now also it will work only if you don't stay either more than 60 days or not more than 365 days in 4 years. Because 365 in 4 years means hardly they are allowing not more than 100 days. You understand? तुझे एक साल में 100 के ऊपर नहीं रुकना है यहाँ पे फिर. And then it's okay because you are using nominal amount of resources, not like you and me that every day we are using Indian resources. Sometime only you come to India, so we don't want tax from you on your foreign income. We will take tax from you only on Indian income if you have. Hello?
Yes.
Is that simple? You are getting my point?
Yes.
See, I am teaching you at some different level. If you look at this condition somewhere later, no? They're very simple. Stay out kitna chahiye. Pehla condition kitna? 182 days. Second condition kitna? 60 days. Uska part bhi kya hai? Stay out 365 days. Kitne saal mein? 4 years. Itna simple hai. Chalte chalte chai peete peete. Restaurant kaise bante yaar? Are 182 days rukna hai bas. Nahi ruka to? To 60 days se zyada rukna hai. Aur phir yaad rakh, wo 365 days wala bhi hai, but out of 4 years. Okay? Itna simple hai. Can I go ahead? Sir, this is how you will become resident. Sir, ek baar resident ban gaya to theek hai. Aage kya banna hai phir? Bolo na, agar main 180 days rukta hu har saal, if I stay India in for 120 days every year, to yahan pe kitna aayega? 4 years ka kitna aayega? 120 plus 120 plus 120 plus 120, 480. Am I satisfying the second part also?
Yes.
Yes, to dono ho jayenge. Then you will declare me resident, okay? But there is nothing called resident as a status. Either I have to become ordinary resident or non-ordinary resident. So ordinary hai, non-ordinary hai, wo check karne ke liye, you need to check whether additional conditions are satisfied or not. And additional condition ke dono ke beech mein kya hai yahan pe? And that means you need to satisfy both additional condition to become OR. To agar ek bhi satisfy nahi karta, ya dono satisfy nahi karta, to you are already resident. But then you will become non-ordinary resident. Resident to pehle se ban chuka hai. Yes or no?
Yes.
Alright. So either you are a resident or ordinary resident or non-ordinary resident. OR and NR. OR kaise bante hai, sir? This is very simple. 730 days out of 7 years. 730 days out of
7
years. 730 days out of 7 years. So language kya dekho? 7 stay of 730 days or more where?
In India.
In India during
7 years
immediate preceding previous year. तुमको समझ रहा है? तो ये condition check करने के लिए तुम्हारे पास 8 year का passport होना चाहिए. Any client का तुम्हारे पास 8 year, because these 7 years are preceding to
previous year.
वहाँ तक condition check करने के लिए you must have 5 years का passport. To check basic condition you must have 5 years passport, because previous year and preceding 4 years. Are you getting my point? Okay, so ye condition ho gaya 730 out of 7 years, and you should be resident. You should become
resident.
How to become resident by satisfying basic condition? You should be resident in India at least for 2 years or more in India during 10 years preceding to previous year. To check this condition, you must have passport date of 11 years. Hello?
Yes.
Checking residential status, theoretically, is just a game for you guys. Okay, just a game. But tomorrow if some client comes, sir, this is my 11 year passport, and that he will come with bag. And then you have to compute residential status. I believe you will invest a lot of energy and time into just determining residential status, and that too, you don't have to determine only for one nation. You have to determine it for all nations wherever he has visited, because you must have understanding. Because he may know, if he become resident in USA, you must understand even USA have residence taxation rule. So Indian income will become taxable in USA. Okay, so this can happen. Possibilities are there in practical life. Theoretical life. एकदम सिंपल सा क्वेश्चन आता है, यू नीड टू काउंट नंबर ऑफ डेज. ओके, आई बिलीव यू कैन काउंट नंबर ऑफ डेज. अप्रैल में कितने दिन होते हैं? 30. मई में? जून? अगस्त? जुलाई? पक्का? बाजू बाजू में आते ना, लेकिन वो चलता है ओके फेब 28 अभी ठीक है अभी 29 कब होगा कमिंग ईयर नहीं वो कब आता है चार साल में लीप ईयर आई नो लीप ईयर विल कम इन फोर इयर्स बट व्हाट इज नेक्स्ट लीप ईयर कमिंग लीप ईयर फेब 20 व्हाट वाज द लास्ट लीप ईयर फेब 2016 तो जब फेब 2016 यू विल हैव इन योर कैलकुलेशन यू नीड टू टेक 29 डे इतना नॉलेज होना चाहिए सर नहीं है तो जाके कैलेंडर लेके बैठो ऑलराइट वो मैं नहीं पढ़ा सकता कौन से मंथ में कितने डेज आते हैं That much can I expect from you?
Yes.
Thanks for your support. Okay. So what you can conclude after reading this whole chart that Mr. Dash, whatever is your assessee, is a resident and ordinary resident for AY 1920. When it is possible? If he satisfy basic condition and both additional condition. Sir, he satisfy basic condition but not additional condition, then he will become resident and non-ordinary resident for AY 1920 and if it doesn't satisfy basic condition only you don't have to check additional conditions you don't have to even write it directly you can write conclusion this assessee is non-resident for AY 1920 am I clear okay now our institute CA institute write this answers in assessment year form I don't know why your institute write it in previous year form okay so what you should do ideally you write both For assessment year 1920, that means previous year, that is na IE, that is previous year 1819. Confusion is clear. Whether to write answer in AY or PY, write both. Okay, koi clarity, matlab koi confusion nahi, full clarity. Alright. Now, notes. Ab ek question kya aata hai logon ke man mein? Then this is very much normal question. I don't know why you people are not asking me question. Have I ever told you like do not ask me questions? You can keep asking me question. Only the question should be sensible one. Okay? Unrelated to chapter when recording is on. Unrelated question when recording is off. Okay? Sir, this stay should it be continuous in nature? 182 days one shot aisa hona chahiye? Was it written there 182 days continuous in nature? Aisa likha tha? Nahi. That means this can be non-continuous. This can be in multiple visit. Right? To greatly abhi aya, fir gaya, fir aya, fir gaya, fir aya, fir gaya. It can happen multiple times in a year. So it can be non-continuous also. We did not say it has to be continuous in nature. Otherwise nobody will become resident. Because if today is 182 days, you will go outside India for one day and then again you will come back. No, it can be non-continuous in nature. Secondly, they sometimes say SSC came at this day and they stayed in India for 300 days. So tumko to lagta hai resident ho gaya. Beta 115 previous year and 115 current year. It has to be cut in years. Please understand. Tumhara time start hota hai on 1st April. You need to focus only on data from 1st April to 31st March. 1st April to 31st March. 1st April to 31st March. Every financial year is an independent year. वो क्या करेगा वो लास्ट ईयर के हाफ सेकेंड हाफ में आएगा और करंट ईयर के सेकेंड हाफ में चला जाएगा सो यू विल हैव 300 डेज बट 150 फॉलिंग इन प्रीवियस ईयर एंड 150 ओनली फॉलिंग इन करंट ईयर यू विल लुक एट 300 हाँ रेसिडेंट रेसिडेंट ऐसे नहीं होता ही शुड स्टे इन इंडिया ड्यूरिंग अरे क्या लैंग्वेज था 182 डेज ड्यूरिंग प्रीवियस ईयर तो मैंने ये नहीं बोला टोटल 180 डेज 182 ड्यूरिंग भी इंपॉर्टेंट है ना यार ड्यूरिंग प्रीवियस ईयर ही मस्ट स्टे इन इंडिया फॉर मोर देन 182 days. Are we clear about this? Okay, can I go ahead? Now, in the absence of information and only in the absence of information, okay, if there is some information, then follow the information of the question. If there is no information of the question, then this thing comes in mind. I don't have marker. Let us assume here, you landed in India at today's night, okay, 23, airport follow 24 hours watch, 23-55. मतलब 11:55 at night you landed in India today you are in India only for 5 minutes yes. shall we count today ka date in number of this day because one day also matters here one day here and there 181 182 okay so shall we count today ka date in that calculation answer is yes when you left India your flight was at 0001 12:01 So on that day you were in India only for 1 minute. Shall we count that day also, sir? Answer is yes, in the absence of information. Sometime question will give you precise information. The assessee was in India up to 19th Feb. On 20th Feb, assessee left India. So don't check that. Assessee was in India. It was clearly written. Assessee was in India up to 19th. So 20th Feb pe kahan soya wo apne ko se lena dena nahi hai. He might have gone.